Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. So in this video, I want to talk about Ridiculous Fishing, A Tale of Redemption. There's a lot of history behind this title, which I had the pleasure of just reading about from various gaming journalism articles and stuff. Really interesting history of... So this game actually basically started out as a free flash game on the internet, and it was free to play for anyone. And back then it was called Radical Fishing. And... you know, the development team behind that was planning to make a paid mobile game, but in the process, a game company saw that flash game, took all of those ideas, and then changed a little things like, you know, it's a ninja fishing. So ninja fishing came out, and there was a whole, you know, debacle that's really detailed well in the link that I put in the video description. So it's a really interesting case history. And ninja fishing, of course, because the idea is such a great idea to, you know, you fish and then you control the reel on the phone. I control it by tilting left and right. On the way down, I try to avoid as many fish and stuff as possible and go to as deep underwater as possible until the reel is maxed out or I hit a fish. And then on the way up, I want to catch as many fish as possible. And then once I hit the surface, all the fish that I caught go all up in the air, and I just tap the phone wildly, like just with shooting weapons and guns at the fish in flying in the air. It's such an amazing concept. So I can totally understand why a game company would take that and just pretty much clone it. The case of cloning is pretty serious. They even copied right down to all the power-ups in the game, like, were exactly identical from Radical Fishing and Ninja Fishing. So this really demoralized the development team behind Radical Fishing and Ridiculous Fishing. So they put it off for a while, and then they released this another really cool game app on the App Store, which I still have not played, but I really want to, because now I play Ridiculous Fishing. I really like these developers. And then after that, they're like, okay, we're going to go back to Ridiculous Fishing. We're going to make this game happen. And they did. And they put having played both Ninja Fishing and Ridiculous Fishing, what's really evident to me is, I mean, I understand why a game mechanic cannot be copyrighted. I would not want to live in a world where gaming mechanic is copyrighted, because that would be pretty horrible. You know, I think there is some talent behind seeing a flash game in its basic form and just pretty much taking that concept and creating your own game out of that, with, you know, with the little twist being that you're a ninja and then you slice a fish in the air with swords, and creating a microtransaction model with it so that, you know, it encourages people to purchase in-app purchases. So the developers behind Ninja Fishing, I actually give them credit for being able to do that, even though the idea of this game is not not from them. They copied it from someone else, or they got it from someone else and pretty much copied the idea. But I think there is still kind of risk and development and talent for that that it takes to make that. And Ninja Fishing, if that was like the only game of this type that I played, I would have been pretty impressed. It has pretty, you know, interesting, quirky, charming 3D graphics. The fish are, you know, pretty cute to look at. And, you know, there's definitely, it's a fun little title. It's free. There's different upgrades. There's a lot of great ideas behind it that was taken from these guys. So Ninja Fishing is okay. But then I played Ridiculous Fishing, and the difference is just immense. With Ninja Fishing, I'm like, all right, this is a cool little app. With Ridiculous Fishing, A Tale of Redemption, I'm playing this and constantly I'm thinking, wow, they put so much love and sweat and effort into this game. I can really feel it. Even though this is a 2D game and Ninja Fishing has 3D graphics, just the art style, the musical background, and all the little tidbits that went into Ridiculous Fishing is amazing. They have this whole, you know, so the Fisher... The main interface that you use to buy upgrades, to look up the fish encyclopedia, which, you know, which has information about different fish you catch or will want to catch, you use like a tablet or in-game tablet. So there's a tablet inside the game that the game character uses. And that tablet has this like social app. And that has been like just seeing that of this game is amazing. It costs $2.99, and right after that there is no microtransaction whatsoever. In fact, the progression in this game is so incredibly exciting because you can earn so much money with just one little fishing that you're constantly buying new equipment, buying new things, buying new stuff. And it keeps making you go further and further. Ninja fishing is like the opposite. It's so little money that you have to keep grinding and grinding and grinding. If you really want to like get the most out of that game really fast, you do have to use real money for its microtransactions, for its in-app purchases, which, like a lot of models, is fairly expensive and really overpriced. So you can see the goal of that game is to get you to reuse real money to buy stuff. Whereas the goal with Ridiculous Fishing, to me, it's just like, hey, you bought this game, thank you so much, and here is our love of game making that we put so much effort into this. Play it, enjoy it. That's pretty much the message I got from Ridiculous Fishing. As a concept itself, it's not like super exciting, you know, tilting your head, tilting the phone this way and that to make the reel go down. But there's just so many unique things in here. The art style, the upgrades. First of all, like, I have to say, like, the orbital ray is freaking amazing. I eventually got enough money to buy the bazooka to blow fish. But the bazooka, even though it's the most expensive weapon, is actually not as effective as the orbital ray, which is such a creative concept that you, like, hold down, you know, you tap the screen and you hold down to make the targeting go bigger and bigger and bigger, and then you let go and everything in that targeting range is destroyed. And you can actually tap it too to become like a laser beam. Weapons are awesome, the details are awesome, and the ending was actually pretty surprising to this game. So that's also another thing that separates from a game of this type. It's not like an endless runner, endless fishing game. It's not, you grind, sure, but you're constantly getting money, enough money to keep upgrading, or it just constantly pushes you. There's enough variety in the music and in the environments. And then the ending was pretty fantastic. It's, whoa, what the heck is this little thing doing at the bottom of the ocean? And then you come out and just like, wow, so that is, this game is called Ridiculous Fishing, subtitle, A Tale of Redemption. So keep in mind that it has that subtitle, and that actually has meaning. I actually do agree with kind of the journalists that think this is maybe a metaphor for the development cycle inside behind this game. They had to go through a lot of troubles to make this game possible. It's out. You know, guys, like, if you enjoy gaming on your iPhone and stuff, or if you just, you know, would like something to kill time and just be really impressed, support these guys. Like, buy Ridiculous Fishing. Really awesome game. And then check out Ninja Fishing and see for yourself, like, the amount of difference between a labor of love and a game that's meant to just make as much profit as much as possible through purchases.